A chainsaw rumbles to life, an innocent victim screams and runs away. The movie cuts away just in time, and we all know the victim is doomed. In popular culture and media, people's psychopathy and sociopathy are always displayed as ravenous murderers in dark alleyways and smelly rooms, ready for the kill. But is that really the truth? What is a psychopath or sociopath? How are they different? And what, if any, are their weapons of choice? Well, we brain junkies need to know the truth. But before we find out our answers to these pressing questions, make sure you subscribe to our channel and comment on your favorite movie featuring psychopaths, or wait for the question we have for you at the end of this video. Now, with that said, on Brief Brain Facts, we're exploring antisocial personality disorder, or what's commonly known as psychopathy or sociopathy. A personality may be considered maladaptive when the affected individual's behavior negatively impacts those around them, or a proportion of society at large, and does so on a regular basis. These behaviors may result in negatively affecting the individual producing them, but it doesn't always, especially in a society or situation where certain problematic behaviors are encouraged. This may certainly be the case for those with antisocial personality disorder, or ASPD, a disorder that has nothing to do with introversion, or being shy or awkward in social situations. People with the disorder are those who show consistent behavioral patterns that include impulsivity, dishonesty, selfishness, manipulation, and shallow emotions. Though, more commonly, they're known as sociopaths or psychopaths, where the defining trait of those with ASPD is an utter disregard for the rights and welfare of others. People with ASPD often use people for their own personal gain. According to researchers and the Diagnostic Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, the DSM, ASPD affects about 3% of any given population, with 1% of females and 4 to 6% of males meeting diagnostic criteria for ASPD. Interestingly, researchers debate as to whether sociopathy or psychopathy belong as subcategories of ASPD. In 1835, ASPD was identified by J.C. Picard as moral insanity. He defined this condition as a disorder of moral understanding that did not affect one's intellect. The general term psychopath did not emerge until the late 1800s, and it was considered a genetic defect. During the early 1900s, with the rise of sociology, the influence of societal conditions were stressed, and the term psychopathy was revised to sociopathy, whereby the individual's problematic behavioral traits were a product of their environment, having nothing to do with their innate state of being. However, it is now understood to be a product of both environment and inherited traits, in which the environment may result in the manifestation of traits like manipulativeness and superficial charm, while traits such as shallow emotional states and lack of empathy may be inherited. Over time, psychopathy developed into the broader disorder known as ASPD. However, the fifth iteration of the DSM has distinguished sociopathy and psychopathy as subcategories of ASPD. People meeting diagnostic criteria for either psychopathy or sociopathy share common traits. Those shared behavioral traits include a disregard for laws and established norms, a disregard towards other people's rights, a potential for violent behavior, and an inability to feel guilty or remorseful for their misdeeds. However, differences between the two exist. For instance, psychopaths are unable to formulate genuine emotional attachments with others and are unable to feel empathy. Additionally, psychopaths are charming despite their ability to manipulate others. What makes psychopaths a potential societal danger is the fact that they are difficult to identify due to their charm, intelligence, and ability to mimic emotions, despite their inability to legitimately feel the emotions they're mimicking. According to researchers, psychopaths are capable of holding steady jobs and are able to develop long-term relationships. Regarding the criminal aspect of the disorder, psychopaths are exacting and well-organized. As such, they tend to be successful white-collar criminals. Sociopaths differ from psychopaths in that they may have a clear sense of right from wrong, but their idea of right and wrong differs from that of the dominant culture in which they live. This distinction is vital when it comes to potential brain differences between those with ASPD and healthy people. Regarding the criminal aspect of sociopathy, crimes committed by sociopaths tend to be disorganized as opposed to well-planned. Thus, unlike the crimes committed by the criminal psychopaths, crimes associated with sociopaths tend to be crimes of passion. With that said, since societal norms may influence some of this behavior, some of these behaviors may exhibit in large groups together, such as in early 20th century Germany during the rise of antisemitism. In this example, individuals across the country exhibited sociopathic behaviors that dismissed the concerns and rights of millions of people living in and around Germany at the time. However, not all ASPD individuals are punished for the criminal exploits And not all ASPD individuals are criminals in the traditional sense, as they sometimes are embezzlers, tax evaders, fraudulent businessmen, corrupt stockbrokers, and conniving attorneys who habitually commit white-collar crimes. According to a recent report regarding U.S. white-collar crimes, the prosecution of white-collar crimes have substantially decreased by nearly 30% from 5 years ago. Yet the rate of white-collar crimes being committed have largely gone unchanged. So if you're going to commit a white-collar crime, now may be the time. But of course, we don't condone criminal activity. Psychopaths who are considered successful are more likely to have higher IQs, are to be of affluence, and more interestingly, may be less likely to seek out high-risk behaviors, as they may be capable of recognizing fear in others and may be capable of feeling fear themselves, unlike their less successful counterparts. Yet not all ASPD individuals commit crimes, especially in the legal sense. They may simply manipulate and use others for their own personal gain, living what appears to be a crime-free life by most standards. The distinction between sociopaths and psychopaths are vital for understanding the underlying brain mechanisms involved in both ASPD types. As I stated earlier, sociopaths appear to have a sense of morality. Researchers propose that antisocial behavior found in sociopathy may likely impact brain areas associated with belief. Thus, it may be a belief that has promoted potential dysfunctions in the brain. This is best demonstrated in case studies and other areas of research that have focused on acquired sociopathy. In these cases, damage to the brain involving areas of the prefrontal cortex have resulted in behaviors seen in sociopaths. A famous case involves Phineas Gage. In the mid-1800s, Gage sustained a devastating injury to what researchers now believe to be the ventromedial prefrontal cortex, or VMPFC. The injury resulted in a complete personality shift. He went from being a responsible, upstanding individual to being somewhat of a vagrant. While this is the most famous case, other and more recent cases have been studied. These personality shifts that lead to acquired sociopathy are seen in those who've sustained damage to areas within the frontal lobe, specifically the VMPFC and the orbitofrontal cortex, or OFC, areas of the brain associated with beliefs and making judgments. Importantly, empathy circuits in the brains of sociopaths may be intact, with no structural or functional abnormalities. On the other hand, brains of psychopaths most likely reflect an inherited predisposition to traits associated with ASPD, as they seem to lack affective awareness and a sense of morality from an early age. They may even be diagnosed with ASPD by the age of 18. Psychopaths may also lack a clear belief system and ideology, thereby conforming to anything that will promote their own interests. Just as behavioral overlaps are noted with sociopaths and psychopaths, there is some overlap regarding areas of the brain that may give rise to antisocial behavior seen in both variants of ASPD. This overlap is seen within the frontal cortex, particularly the OFC. However, additional areas of the brain are implicated in psychopathy, giving rise to the idea that psychopathy may be the result of widespread brain dysfunction. Areas of the brain that may be dysfunctional in psychopaths include limbic and paralimbic structures, in addition to front cortical areas such as the VMPFC, OFC, and the anterior cingulate cortex, or ACC. These areas of the brain are related to planning and processing of reward and emotional processing. Thus, disruption in the overall circuitry may be related to particular symptoms noted in psychopathy, such as goal-directed aggression, callousness, and a sense of grandiosity. ASPD is problematic. In worst-case scenarios, those exhibiting these behaviors are serial or mass murderers. They may also be social cheaters who have no problem with hurting others in order to ensure that their interests are met. They may be easily identified, as is the case with some well-known serial killers, or may be someone who takes advantage of others in an environment where such behaviors are typically rewarded, such as the case with the individuals who, during the recession of 2008, illegally foreclosed people's homes in order to assure their own financial success. The distinction between psychopathy and sociopathy is not entirely settled, yet there is evidence based on brain dysfunction that supports making said distinction. As such, those with psychopathy pose the biggest threat, as they often go undetected and, when identified, are often immune to treatment. Luckily, behaviors associated with psychopathy have been shown to decrease with age. In contrast, sociopathy has been shown to develop in those experiencing age-related dementia. Our brains are complicated organs with fascinating variation. They can be influenced by genetics and our environment, like the culture in which we live. Those with ASPD may not all chase teenagers around with chainsaws, but they do exist as more proof that the brain is an amazing place and even susceptible to cultural influences. Have you ever met someone you just knew was a psychopath or sociopath? Comment below. If you liked what you saw, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. And head over to our Patreon page for updates and perks for our members. As always, thank you for watching.